Good morning, dear students. Today we will start our next lesson. Already we learned before fiber to fabric lesson. Okay. Now the question answers, worksheet, and test also completed. So today we will start next lesson, that is physical and chemical changes. Okay. See, in this lesson, physical and chemical change. In this lesson, these points we are going to cover. So first is introduction about changes, how it occurs, okay, that all we will see. Then second point is physical change, third chemical change, fourth rusting of iron, and last one is crystallization. So in this whole lesson, these all points we are going to cover. Okay, so before to start the actual point, means what actual lesson, that is the physical and chemical change. What do you know about physical and chemical changes? At least you know about the changes. What are the changes? Just think that and write some examples in your notebook. Okay, so now we will discuss about the change. Now change means what? See, every day the changes occurs in our life. Okay, everything. Suppose now here this is this one is a book. Okay, if I will fold this book, then see size change, shape change. So this change occurs means when we apply the force and pressure, that time also changes occurs. Okay, if you will take one page of this notebook and you will cut into a small pieces, so what, that is also change. Okay, that is also change. Now see here, I example, that is a haircut. See, after haircut, see, your total look is different. Okay, so that one is also changes. So these changes are occurs every day. And so many changes, the seasons change, okay, rainy season, summer season. So these all are the changes. So these all changes are divided into the most two types. There are the different types, there are many types, okay. But now in this year, we are going to discuss about, in detail study about physical and chemical change, okay. So what is a definition of change? See, change means what? Anything that becomes different. See, change means what? Anything that becomes different undergoes a change. Means after change, it will look different. Now for example, suppose, see here, this is one paper. Okay, this paper, I will cut into a small pieces. Like this. Now see here, it will look different. Yes, so this change occurs. This is also known as a change. Suppose if you will burn this paper with the providing heat. Okay, if you will burn this paper, then what? You will get powder in the powder form. That is ash. Okay, if you will burn paper, then you will get it in a powder form, that is ash. So this is also change. So these changes are occur every day in daily life. Okay, so what exactly definition of change? Anything that becomes different undergoes a certain change, that is only known as a change. Okay, so there are main two types, that are physical and chemical change. Okay, so we will see a first change, that is physical change. Okay, write this all information in your notebook. So see, the first example, first change that we will see, that is a physical change. What do you know about the physical properties? Physical properties. See, if you will take any substance, the change occur in their physical properties. For example, state, shape, color, size. if that physical properties will change, means what? That totally this change occur in this physical change, mostly change occur in their states. Now states, which are states? Solid, liquid and gaseous. Okay, these three states, if change occur in these states, then also it is physical change. For example, then next one physical property, that is a shape. Okay, shape, suppose in front of you one sponge is there. If you will apply the pressure, then sponge, that size will, shape will change and it will come into its original position. Okay, so that is also one example of physical change. So what exactly physical change? Physical change means change occurs in state, shape, size, color, okay, and their chemical properties retain as it is. Means what? There is no change in the chemical properties. There will be the change in the physical properties. These are the physical properties, that is state, shape, size, colors change. Okay, and the original substance we will get back, means what? The physical change. For example, now I will give you an example. See, a stretching of rubber. Okay, if you will stretch the rubber, size will change, shape will change, and again it will come into its original position. So this is also one example of physical change. See, now just I am giving you some examples. In detail we will learn what is a physical change. Okay, so these physical change means the change occur in their physical properties. And which are the physical properties? State, shape, size, color. Okay, maybe change occur in shape, size, state, color. So that all the examples of physical change. For example, now see in a state, see in this beaker, what is there? Water. Okay, in this beaker, water. When you will heat this water, okay, what? Steam will come out. Means this water will convert into water vapors. And after cooling this water vapor, when you will cool this water vapor, means condensation process. See, now condensation means what? That we learn already. Okay, while the condensation process, this water vapors again it converted into a water drops. Okay, so we'll get the original substance back. Means first water, which is in a liquid state, it converted into water vapor, that is in a gaseous state. And after the condensation, again that water vapor converts into water droplets, that is again in a liquid state. So this change occurs in their states, that is known as a physical change. Means in this physical change, the change occurs in the physical properties of that particular substance, and the original substance, whatever it is that we will get back, that is only known as a physical change. Okay, definition and in detail some examples we will learn in next lecture. Thank you.